one Protestant school in Hatford that was non-fee the rest was payment. But she has all that information. What's interesting though, Kilcona had a head school. More parish up there than they are here. You know, celebrating things. So, commemorating things.
You and my boy don't fear, and Over and sat on the floor, and he looked up for, you know, quite long sauna.
Yeah. You have a set to that room. That's mm. really, there is one room in the car cabin that's well haunted.
Yes, there is. Oh, there is.
He might be torn.
There is one room.
It's about a third. I would want to say that now, but because my mother was there. And
yeah. Of course, that marriage. She always comes back.
It's a sort of reincarnation.
She came back as a mouse.
Yeah. It says now you see a mouse. You know,
looking up at that, but he did that.
I said, that's an awful sight. And she never slept in that room. She told them about it. And they locked the room. And I think that's the room. Because the woman that owned it, she was Miss Craven, Miss Isla Craven, and you know, there was only Pat Martin and Julie now going in there that night. And there was a drum of Paris and I left in the pub. You know, to sit there, like, you know,
yeah.
But Pat just went and my mother, and this is for fear, but God, I couldn't see how many years ago.
Well, she was
60. But she talked about that night, mom,
maybe you want to go in the bedroom.
I wouldn't think so. I don't know.
So we in our memory. It's the place we were born and raised. It's long years ago since we left it. But the time there we will it with faith. Then Murphy would bring down the fiddle. One daughter looked after the store. The music did ring and sweet songs we did sing. On stone outside and Murphy's door. Those days in our hearts we will cherish, contented although we were poor. And songs as we sung in the days we were young, on the stone outside and Murphy's door. When our day's work was over, we'd meet there in the winter or springtime the same. The boys and the girls all together, then we'd join in some innocent game. Our friends and companions of childhood would assemble each night near a shore. The music did ring and sweet songs did sing on the stone outside Dan Murphy's door. Those days in our hearts we will cherish, contented although we were poor. But the songs that we sung in the days we were young on the stone outside Dan Murphy's door.
Now it's time to make them up again. Sure aren't we all very shiny now? Now it's time to step together now. We're on the one road to the one road. We're on the road till God knows where. We're on the one road, maybe the wrong road, but we're together now, who cares? Northmen, Southmen, Conway's all, Dublin, Galway, Cork and Donegal. We're on the one road, swinging along, singing a soldier's song. We're on the one road, cheering the one road. We're on the road to God knows when. We're on the one road, maybe the wrong road, but we're together now, who cares? Northmen, Southmen, Conway's all, Dublin, Galway, Cork and Donegal. We're on the one road, singing along, singing a soldier's song. And then I'm flooring breath, sure my heart keeps getting faster. And look by one and all, and no one thinks of mixing. For anyone who thinks history trousers needs this kitchen, singing toodle-loodle-la, toodle-loodle-la-dee, toodle-loodle-la, toodle-loodle-la-dee. A man came in one day, Pat Maloney's father, he caught me by the coat, saying, why did you hit me, buddy? Should I just look down and laugh for the super satisfaction? For I'll do that then he wouldn't know to see that man in action. Singing, toodle-loodle-la, toodle-loodle-la-dee, toodle-loodle-la, toodle-loodle-la-dee. On the green banks of Shannon, where she and I, no brighter east and was so happy as I, no harp like my own could so cheerfully play. When the sow looking so sick, my heart is a raging in day. Turello, sure as 6 miles from Bangor to Dunahabby. When the day was so wet and the night was so cold, and Pat and his jar were going weary and old. When the sour-looking folk set my heart is away, sure that always a friend in my poor dog would say, Turello, Turele, sure it's 6 miles from Bangor to Dunahabby.
We met and we married a long time ago. We worked for long hours and wages were low. No TV, no wireless, no bath, times were hard. Just a cold water wash and a walk in the yard. No fridges, no freezers, no carpet on floors. We had turf on the fire and no locks on the doors. Our children arrived, no pill in these days, and were brought up without any state aid. Our children were safe to play in the field or the park, and the old ones could go for a walk in the dark. No vandals, no muggings, there was sick all to rob. We felt very rich with a couple above. No capsules, no tablets, or no Dr. C. We cured most of our ills with a good cup of tea. People were happy in those far-off days, kinder and caring in so many ways. We all had our share of trouble and strife. You just have to face it, that's the pattern of life. Now that we are old and look back on the years, we don't think of the bad times, the trouble and tears. We remember our blessings, our home and our love, that we share them together. We thank God above.
Thank you.
Poor but happy days. Thank you, Gerald. In my young days was so different in so many ways. There was Nina Hens, Fallons, Cravens and Flynn's at the top, who always did good trade on our usual stuff. Flanagan's with the chip shop and the restaurants were grand, and then across the Canavans where toys were displayed in a stand. Further down Main Street was McCormick's Hotel, which usually had friends and some stories to tell. Flanagan's chemist and Jimmy Welch's next door, on to the post office, which isn't there anymore. Then on to Sean Ford's for a sing-song, where Keynes and Brendan Burke had the crack all night long. The town now lives on, but most old residents are gone. All we have now are memories of building around.
Hills are green and fluffed over. They're filled with leaves of luscious clover. The water from your river low to Loch Connell silent and gently flow. Your churchyard it is there up high, where your dear ones peacefully now lie. Once to that old church they came to pray, and to that old school they walked each day. Your people there are loyal and true to our little shrine of white and blue. And now when people pass that way, to that sweet lady a homage pay. Your castle there in ruins still stands, where once lived the lord who owned your land. Your forefathers bravely fought and won, and regained the land you now proudly own. Stand on your green hill and see from there Loch Connell and its islands bare, where fishermen will dap in mid and catch brown trout round Quickalvay. Let's drink a toast to Clochan over at the tavern where all good people hover. They come to hear sweet music play, and they sing and dance their cares away.
Was that?
And your mom was always in Cumberland when I was young.
It never got it exactly.
Oh. Well, they called the blue sisters, didn't they?
Yeah.
Huh?
Mm. We didn't know anything that time about corruption or anything. It was all swept under the carpet. Nothing was brought out in the open that time. Everything was done privately.
I remember a story that my oldest uncle told, and the blue shirt marched into his village. He's 87 this year. This month, yesterday he was 87, as a matter of fact. And at 5 years of age, the blue shirts marched into his village and ordered his father, my grandfather, out of the house, along with the other men in the village, and as they waited for my grandfather to come out of the house, as a young lad skipping up and down, he actually grabbed one of the rifles from the soldiers and was let away with it. So he can boast from that day to this, that he took a rifle from one of the blue shirts. But as it happened, my grandfather was lucky to come back to the village. But there was a lot of men that didn't come back. They simply disappeared. And so that would be 82 years ago when they marched into the village. So, and that was in a scum French park. So it was all around that time.
What were the blue shirts?
They were called blue shirts.
They were, right?
Because of their uniform, they wore blue shirts.
Were they thinking of all? No, I don't know.
No, there were different. There were.
Yes, I think there were.
I was taught, the blood and transferred my in-laws house in Mount Cross because it was so near the lake and wanted to get her across to freedom away from whoever was chasing them. Celia Hines, God rest her, told me that her father threw her out of the window for safety's sake, for fear that they do any harm to her. But they were raided, I don't know how many times, several times.
Yeah, but you see, John Manahan lived there, but
yeah.
His brother was executed in the 1916 rising outside the courthouse and so on. There was how many of them, 12 or 13?
John Yule's uncle.
Yes,
the man John Yule was there.
Yeah.
His uncle.
Yeah.
Was
executed? Yes, executed.
Yeah.
For what? Well, I don't know. But the night before he died, anyway, he was a great friend of my father. It's Michael Manning, his name. And he left a note to his mother, and it should break the heart of his stone. The note he left saying he was gone since that following morning. You know, I don't know what they were. We used to have a picture of them, but I can't think of them.
They were all lined up against the wall.
They were.
How many of them did they have?
There was Conan, one of the Conans.
I think
Marion Murphy has a picture. She has.
Mm-hmm. the Black and Tan used to burn houses anyway. They burned my uncle's house in Dooney. Where Joe is living now. Daddy, they burned it. And you know, you have no idea where Monavie and near FNI is. Happy up. That's right. When my mother came from there, and she was one day on her own, and her four of them came outside. Thomas just smelled not good. And she said that the minute she opened the door, she said that her brother ran up the stairs and he hid in an old wardrobe. And she said they came to the door and they said, is your brother in? She said, no. And she said she could hear the wardrobe creaking upstairs. And they said they'd leave her at that, like, that wouldn't bother, you know, being testified, you know, freedom. Chris, how are you? Have you any store for us?
I live in the city of Dublin, business of my own. Sure, I own the tailor shop. Sure, my name is on the top. Sure, I'll do my business in my own right shop. A man came in the other day to buy a suit of clothes. I offered him up for 12 and 6 from head to toe to top. He pushed me in the corner. That's the case for you. But if you don't shore up, but if you don't shore up, for you still and have a show middle in your own right shop.
Something the last year we were about the market. Market time. Is there any room where that's an interesting anecdote from you? The market?
The fair, I think.
All right.
The fair for on the street.
There's a spot in the cupboard I know, where all good fishermen go, for that herd all about the brown spotted trout. And when the weather is fine, he'll appear with his line, and early in May, you will hear them say, come fish in the waters of Holland of Bay. The water's so clear, the boatman can steer through the rocks that are there, near the island so there. And the wild birds will fly as the boat it goes by. They fish there all day. In the evening they say, the fishing is good in Ballandofay. In summer, the people come here to bathe in the water so clear. There is lovely white sand, it's the best in the land. They'll find peace of mind nowhere else they can find. They lay there all day, in the evening they stay. The bathing is lovely in the land of bay. When the winter comes round and the frost on the ground, the fowler sits tight when the moon's shining bright. With his dog at his heel, he begs mallard and teal. Then he's up and away, to himself he will say, the shooting is good in Ballinrobin. Now the spring wells are found, rising up from the ground. The water so cold, there come young and old, to fill their tin cans, or drink from their hands. You'll hear them say, you don't have to pay to drink the pure waters in the land of bed. Farewell to the day when the landlord held sway and the bailiff he carved the shore. And thank God that those days are no more. For the big house is gone, our forefathers won. They chased the old bailiff away. Never more will he say, don't dare the same fortune round the land of them. The castle stands bold, it is centuries old. You can easily tell it was there before Cromwell. Now the small birds are found nesting there all around. You can climb the stairway to the top any day and gaze at the beauty of the land of bed. For there in the spring, when the birds sweetly sing, go there alone and sit on the rock of limestone. Let your mind wander on to your friends now long gone. On their way up to heaven, I pray, the good Lord will say, let's take a last look down over the land of bed. The rooms of Rotherly stand out there so clear, on the banks of the river that flows there so near. The land all around there is luscious and green, once the holy Franciscan prayed there so serene. They toil from dawn to the end of each day, in a tomb of stone, now their sacred bones lay. From Cromwell's cruel soldiers, they had to take flight, or by those cruel tyrants be slain there on sight. Before they departed and said farewell, they took down and hid their beloved old bell, the bell they cherished. Polished and shone, lies deep in the river where they say it has gone. You can climb up the stone stairs to the tower so high, and you know that heaven's beyond the blue sky. You can see Kirkpatrick way down in Mayo, where thousands each year on a pilgrimage go. Where St. Patrick, our patron, fasted and prayed for 40 long nights on his high peak he stayed. And out to those realms and all clusters we tread, when we go there to visit and pray for our dead. On the top of the town, there was a warehouse there. They sold boats and potatoes, eggs, and they weighed them in there. And bonnets, they sold bonnets on a Tuesday too. They weighed them in the wastegate. And all the farmers were there. So it's a big deal for the farmers.
And
their wives. They met, and their wives, of course. And they used to go in for a drink, but the women wouldn't be seen at the bar. They'd go into the snug. And they'd have a glass of Guinness. But it was port at that time, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So then there was a fair every month, the 14th of the month, Catherine T.
How much did you pay at cost for a follow?
The calf was about £2, and the cow was about £6, and the sheep were about £4. That would be in the tractors at the bad time, the tractors.
Mm-hmm.
The economical war or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. Times must have been
awful hard
then.
Oh,
very hard.
Very hard.
Because they all had their own stuff. They
had
potatoes and oats.
But the townspeople must have found
it
hard
then. Oh, they did. Shopkeepers had a hard time because the farmers had no money. They had to wait for somebody to send the sheep or cattle and beef. Then they paid the shopkeeper. Kilroy Cross. And they used to come from miles around on the bicycles, of course. And they stay there until it got dark.
I bet the weather was better.
Beautiful weather. There was no rain. Not one day's rain or nice rain. No. In the summer time.
The weather was finer in those days.
I can't remember any time there was rain at the dance. Then we were so happy we didn't know whether it was rain or not. At the crossroads o'er the hill, near the castle and the mill, in the days before launch bars, he took tax or copper charge. The boys and girls all loved to go to the crossroads of Kinroy. There beneath the beech trees brown, on the roadside they sat down. When they heard the melody and the sweet, all the boys were on their feet. They danced with heel and toe at the crossroads of Kinroy. They danced the Highland fling, all together they did swing. They heard the cotton cray down in the meadow glow, coming from the crossroads of Kinroy. Then they strolled home in the twilight and kissed their sweethearts goodnight. And home they slowly go from the crossroads of Kinroy. Oh, it's lonely now and still at the crossroads o'er the hill. The mill stream keeps rippling on, the boys and girls, they're all gone. back again, they'll never go to the crossroads of Kinross.
Again with a little timber again, a plug. They were able to plug the hole again. So they used to do that every week, coming down the wood. No, they wouldn't be spotted. There was no cars that day.
We all have the first, 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 the first,